Hello students, in last session, the basic introduction about the statistic means the three measures of central tendency, mean, median and mode, as we know. The basic introduction for mean is completed. Mean for group data, mean for ungrouped data. We discussed three methods to finding a mean for group data. The first is example one from our textbook. It is example for ungrouped data whenever the observations and respective frequencies are given. See your textbook first. Whenever you see your e-learning sessions, open your textbook. Take your textbook with yourself. Page number 261. Example 1 is there. See the question. The marks obtained by 30 students of class 10 of a certain school in a mathematics paper consisting of 100 marks are presented in table below. Find the mean of the marks obtained by the students. One horizontal table is given. As we know, the table is in form of ungrouped data, means the observation and respective frequencies are given. The two columns are remaining the same. As we know, the formula to find mean for this data, x bar is equals to sigma xi fi xi upon sigma fi. X bar is equals to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. The sigma fi represent the total number of students. As from the question, the total 30 students of class 10, the total number of students means the sigma fi is equals to 30. Now we find the third column as a fi into xi, and at last find sigma fi xi is equals to 10 ones are 10, 20 ones are 20, 36 threes are 108. Put the unit digit below the unit digit and tens digit below the tens digit. 44 is 160, 53 is 150. It is multiplication of fi with xi or xi with fi. 56 2s are 112, 64 is 240, 280, 72 1s are 72, 80 1s are 80, 88 2s are 176, 92 threes are 276, 95 ones are 95. Now we add fi xi with each other and we get sigma fi xi. Add them. To 9, the carry 2. 6, 1779. Don't write carry in your table. To draw the table, use scale and pencil. To fill up the table, use your pen. The sigma fi is 1779. Now we substitute this into the formula. To find the mean of given data, sigma fi xi is 1779 upon sigma fi is equals to 3030. If possible, then we cut it by 3. 1779 divided by 3, 5, 2 and 7, 0 and 9, 3 threes are 9. 593 by 3 cut is possible, 593, but 10 is in denominator, then it is 59.3. 59.3 is the mean of given data. The question says that find the mean of marks obtained by the students. Therefore, mean of the marks obtained by students is 59.3. Hence, the first example is completed. Now we go through example number 2. See in your textbook page number 267. The mean is also called as average. The second name of mean is also average. If in question, the question is like that, find the average of given data, then it is also mean of given data. The example number 2, see the question on your page number 267. The table below gives the percentage distribution of female teachers in the primary school of rural area of various states as union territories of the India. Find the mean percentage of female teachers by all the three methods discussed in this session, in this section. As we know, there are three methods. First is the direct method, second is the assuming method, and third is the step deviation method. We need to find mean using all three methods. Mean using all three methods are equal. The value of mean is equal in each and every method. The first percentage of female teachers and the number of states means the union territories, the horizontal table is given. Then I draw here a vertical table, percentage female teachers, number of states, union territories. First of all, keep in mind whenever you use the direct method, the four columns are required. Whenever you use assuming method, the five columns are required. And whenever you use the step deviation method, again the five columns are required. In direct method, the four columns are class, frequency, XI and FIXI. In an assuming method, the first is class, frequency, XI, DI and FIDI. Keep in mind always. In a third step deviation method, there are also five columns. One is class, then frequency, then XI, then UI, and last is FIUI. In all three methods, three columns are same. Class and frequency is given in the question. Third is for class mark XI. Then fourth and fifth column is as per requirement or requirement of our method when we use to find the mean of given data. So that keep in mind. But in this example, example number 2, we have to use all three methods to find the mean of given data. So that I draw here a single table for all three methods. The first two columns are from our question. The third column is for class mark. Class mark is represented by XI. As we know, the first is the direct method. For the direct method, four columns are important. The class, number of student states means it is a FI, class mark XI, and here is a FIXI. Rest of other remains as it is. It is our FIXI, but I will write here FIXI. Okay, now we go through find a class mark XI. As we know the class mark XI, to find the class mark XI, addition of upper limit and lower limit or lower limit and upper limit divided by 2, 15 plus 25 divided by 2, the 40 upon 2, which is 20. The class mark for first class interval is 20. Now you see the class size of all class intervals. It is a continuous frequency distribution. First of all, see, the 25 is ending here and the 25 is starting here. In the class interval 20 to 35, 35 is ending here and 35 is the starting here. So that it is a continuous frequency distribution. So that 25 minus 15, we get 10 as the class size. H is equals to 10. In all class intervals, keep in mind one wrong thing. Whenever your class intervals are continuous or discontinuous, if you have to subtract 25 minus 25, 35 minus 25, 45 minus 35, we get a class mark, which is 10. It is a wrong thing, but it correct for continuous frequency distribution as well as discontinuous frequency distribution. But for a continuous frequency distribution, as we know the formula, upper limit minus lower limit. Got it? Very well. Now class size is 10. If you are not able to find using the formula, add 10 to 20, which is 30. Add class size 10 to 30, which is 40. Now next is 50. How it obtained? 45 plus 55 upon 2, which is 100 upon 2, and it gives 50. Here is the 50. Okay, now you know how to obtain class mark. The first class mark is the average of upper limit and lower limit. Then add class size H to the consecutive class marks. 50, then 60, 70 and 80. Not compulsory to use this thing in each and every class mark. Now we multiply Fi with the Xi. To get multiplication of Fi Xi, it gives us sigma Fi X. I 26 are 120, 11 3s are 330, 7 4s are 280, 28 means 0 as it is, 4 5s are 20 means 200, 240 multiplication of Fi with the Xi, 2 7s are 140. And the last is 81s are 80. Now we add Fi Xi to get sigma Fi Xi. The 0 at unit digit. Carry 2. 1390. In your textbook also this type of table is given, the sigma Fi Xi, which is 1390. The table for direct method is completed. Now first we solve mean using the direct method. Mean X bar using direct method. As we know formula, X bar is equals to sigma Fi Xi upon sigma Fi. You think that both equations, both the formulas are equal, but there is a difference. Here Xi is called the value of observation and here Xi is called the class mark for the class intervals. Now we substitute the value of sigma Fi Xi 1390 upon the sigma Fi. The sigma Fi in the question is not given, so that we have to add them. Sigma Fi means the total frequency which is 35. 1390 divide by 35. By 5, 5 cot is first possible. 5 7s are 278. Now we divide 278 by 7. 278 by 7. 21, 68. 7 9s are 63. 5 and 0. 7s are 49. 1 and 0. 1s are 3. 4s are. Our answer, take two digits after the decimal point, 39.71 is equals to 39.71, which is X bar for given frequency distribution mean for given frequency distribution using which method? Using the first direct method. Now we go for finding mean using the second method. The second method is assume mean method. Assume mean method. As we know the formula, first x bar is equals to a plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi. For that, first of all we need a means assume mean. Take a from your xi's column, from the xi. As we know di is equals to xi minus a. Take the fourth column as a di. Di is equals to xi minus a, and here is the column is for fi di. Keep in mind here the fi and is fi di. Fi and di, the multiplication gives us fi di. To find the di, we have to take a from xi. Take 50 as a assuming a. You have to take anything from 20 to 80 as a. The answer will be same. The answer is 39.71 in second method, assuming method also. To find the di, subtract a from xi's. They are the xi's, all class intervals having the same class size. So they find di below side or upside, anyone. Xi minus a, 60 minus 50. In front of a, di is always 0. 60 minus 50, which is 10. 70 minus 50, which is 20. 80 minus 50, which is 30. The gap between two consecutive di's is equals to the class mark h. Now in upside, it is negative. 40 minus 50 minus 10, like this. If you are not able to do directly, use pencil for that. 30 minus 50 minus 20. Here 10, 20, 30 are positive. Upside they are negative. Minus 10, minus 20 and the minus 30. Now we do the multiplication of fi and di. Here is the fi and di. Put your scale on xi because the xi is non-useful here. 6 threes are 18, but it is minus 180. 11 and minus 20, minus 220. 7 and minus 10, minus 70. 4 multiply 0 gives 0. 4 and 10, which is 40. 22s are again 40. 31s are 30. Now we add positive with positive and negative with negative. 40, 40 and 30. 110, negative with negative. 470, we subtract it, 360, but it is a minus 360. It gives us sigma fi di is equals to minus 360. Now the table is completed for our assuming method. In the assuming method, the five columns, class interval, fi, xi, di and fd, fi di is useful. Now we substitute in the formula, a is equals to 50. Plus sigma fi di is equals to minus 360 upon sigma fi, which is 35. The cut is possible here by 5, 5. 5 sevens are and the 72 is equals to 50 plus minus minus. Now we divide 72 by 7. 7 ones are 7, which is 0. Here is the 2, the take 10 here, 0 here. The third digit is 5 or greater than 5, we have to take it 10.29. Now we subtract 10.29 from 50. 10 minus 9, which is 1, 9 minus 2, which is 7, here is the 9, the 9, and 4 minus 1, which is 3, 39.71. See what happened here? The second method, using the assuming method, again mean is the same, 39.71. The second method is completed here. Now the third method, third method is called a step deviation method. Step deviation method. First of all, keep in mind the formula to find mean using the step deviation method. X bar is equals to a plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into h. Here, class size h is the most important thing. Whenever we use the step deviation method, the class size h for all class intervals having the same. Keep in mind, if they are not same, then we don't use the step deviation method. We are using the most appropriate direct method, okay? Now, the first of all, the table is incompleted for the step deviation method. For the step deviation method, the first, second and third column remains the as it is. Then the next fourth column is for ui. Ui is equals to xi minus a upon h. And the last column is the fifth column is for fi ui. Step deviation method is the most easy method. Whenever you have to take a, in front of a, ui is 0. Below side it is negative 1, 2, 3. Upside minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. According to our number line. But it is applicable only for class size are same in the given class interval. Okay, got it? Very well. Now we multiply fi with the ui. Here is the fi and here is the ui. 6 into minus 3, which is minus 18. 11 into minus 2, which is minus 22. 7 into minus 1, which is minus 7. In front of 0, a 0, 4 multiply 0 gives us 0. 4 multiply 1, which is 4. 2 2s are 4. 1, 3s are 3. 4, 4 and 3, 11. Minus 47. It gives us minus 36, which is sigma fi ui. They are fi ui, but addition of them gives sigma fi ui, which is minus 36. Keep in mind, the table is most important thing to solve the mean of the data. Here the class size is used. Class size h is equals to, the class size is 10. Class size 10 is compulsory used in step deviation method. The assumption a is 50. If you are interested, then change it. Draw table again. Sigma fi ui minus 36, sigma fi which is 35, and class size is 10. By 5 cut is possible. 5 7s and 5 2s are 50 plus minus minus 72 upon 7. See here, 72 upon 7 gives us 10.29. 50 minus 10.29. Then the x bar, not compulsory to do subtraction. Subtraction is already here. 39.71. 39.71. Hence, the answer is obtained here. In the question says that we need to find the mean percentage of female teachers by all three methods. The mean percentage of female teachers, hence, mean percentage of female teachers is 39.71 using all the three methods. Hence, all three methods are completed here. In example number 2, the three methods are in combination form. But in next examples, we do it separately, the direct method, the step deviation method and the assumption method. Hope you are getting very well the all three methods. Whenever we meet in next session, we started our example number 3. And compulsory, write this e-learning sessions, all topics in your fair book. Do homework in a separate book. Got it? Very well. Practice, practice and practicing.